Hello, we're the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today's episode will look at some recent SpaceX updates, including the Demo 2 launch. Then we'll take a look at developments in Boca Chica, SN4's recent rapid unscheduled disassembly, SN5 and SN6. Let's head straight in and get up to date. Starting with the SpaceX updates. As you will know, the launch didn't happen on Wednesday. Whilst everything went perfectly, the weather didn't want to let the vehicle launch.
And Dragon SpaceX, unfortunately, we are not going to launch today. You are go for 5.100 launch scrub.
John Innsbrucker, the famous SpaceX livestream host, said, "It's better to be on the ground and wishing you were flying than flying and wishing you were on the ground." Elon Musk tweeted on Saturday about Falcon 9 and Lightning in response to a Soyuz launch which got struck by lightning. He said that Falcon 9 and Dragon are designed to withstand multiple lightning strikes, but we don't think it would be wise to take this risk. However, on Saturday, May 30th, SpaceX made history.
1-0. Ignition. Liftoff of the Falcon 9 and Crew Dragon. Go NASA. Go SpaceX. Godspeed, Bob and Doug.
America has launched.
One Alpha.
So rises a new era of American spaceflight, and with it the ambitions of a new generation continuing the dream. 20 seconds into flight, stage one propulsion is nominal.
The booster B-1058 lifted off for the first time to carry the first American astronauts from US soil to space in 9 years. It then proceeded to perform a first successful landing on drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
We'll wait for confirmation of that landing shortly here.
Falcon 9 first stage successfully landed.
And there you can see on your screen, Falcon 9 has landed. This is the first Falcon 9 to carry humans to orbit, so very exciting for us.
Once Bob and Doug had launched, completed all their tests and got ready for some sleep, they gave a little speech and tour of the capsule. The men, as tradition in US spaceflight, named their capsule.
First is kind of a tradition we've had over the years with spacecraft going way back to the Mercury era. And then a tradition that's been carried on ever since with all our space vehicles, including the Soyuz. We're given the honor to name this capsule. I know most of you at SpaceX especially know it as Capsule 206, but I think all of us thought that we could maybe do a little bit better than that. So without further ado, we would like to welcome you aboard Capsule Endeavour.
Whilst producing this video, they're expected to arrive in the next couple of hours. By the time it's released, they will probably have docked with the ISS. In other news, apparently SpaceX has signed an agreement with the US Army. It will enable the Army to test the Starlink service for 3 years, which will enable them to test whether or not it's a good fit for their needs. Over in Boca Chica, we'll begin with the tents that were recently being extended. You can see here where they recently extended over the existing door of the second tent. That door frame still appears to be there, but it looks like it's in the process of being taken down. Next, over by the new ring building, there are still a whole bunch of stacked and single rings waiting for whatever their fate may be. You can also see there is something interesting inside, but it's not clear what it may be. The tent that I showed by this building last episode appears to be in the process of being deconstructed, as you can see here. Now let's take a look at some licensing provided by the FAA for SpaceX operations. This license allows SpaceX to perform suborbital launches for 2 years under certain conditions. They are required to discover and report any issues that could affect public safety. This is applicable throughout the whole process of any testing they do. Apparently, they were previously set to provide up to $100 million in launch liability insurance for Starship. However, under this new license, that has apparently increased to $198 million. Another document that was released was a NOTAM for space operations. The space ops are permitted for June 1st and up to 26,000 feet. However, I highly doubt now that this is still applicable to SpaceX's goals, as you will find out soon. On to SN4, which in recent days has had a wild ride. As you can see here, it was originally spotted getting a hat. So as it turns out, that welded block of steel we saw last episode was indeed a mass simulator. Its addition was also most likely to simulate the weight of the upper rings and nose cone. Now onto the juicy stuff, where SpaceX recently prepared for and performed the fourth successful static fire of SN4. It was also the second static fire for Raptor SN20 whilst attached to the vehicle. This time though, there was no fire and everything looked good. The next day, they went on to attempt a further static fire. They fueled it up and got it ready. Then they performed yet another successful static fire, and again, everything looked good. This marked the fifth SN4 static fire. However, things then took a turn for the worst. After many a successful test, SpaceX looked to be getting ready for even more testing, but then this happened. The vehicle suffered a rapid unscheduled disassembly, and so its fate was sealed. Whilst SN4 served her purpose very well, her demise finally arrived, and to be honest, I was somewhat expecting it. However, remember that this is SpaceX's process. Rapid iteration, you build it, test it, it fails, you iterate, then repeat the process, so we could see many more failures to come. They've started to clear the debris for this prototype, and I'm sure they'll want to get everything back to being operational again quickly. Looking at the test stand, it looks like some work will be needed to get it back to a point where it's able to support testing again. However, it's now time to move on to SN5 both in the video and in Boca Chica. You can see here the SN5 nose cone ring section that recently got bent by the wind. It appears as though they've done some sort of welding to straighten it out. I'm curious if they will still attempt to use this on a Starship or if it will be used for testing or training. There's also the nose cone, which appears to have new holes integrated into the very top tapered section. I'm not entirely sure what these may be for though. Not much on SN5, but SN6's thrust section is still sitting outside. We saw it was stacked last episode, but it still needs a couple more rings attached. Near the SN5 nose, some new tapered nose cone sections have been spotted. There's also a tapered section spotted in a tent, so we might see a new nose cone very soon. In the high bay, you can see that the section that was sitting in there has got some more rings. I can't see a bulkhead, so I'm going to guess the next things to complete the tank section are thrust stack and upper dome. Here you can see a new upper bulkhead. As a guess, I would say this dome might be for SN6 since we haven't seen an SN6 upper section yet. There's also a new section, as you can see, attached to a crane in the same tent. Looks like it could potentially be moved outside soon, or maybe it's just been moved inside. As always, a massive thanks goes to the amazing Mary Boca Chica girl for the great shots and to the NSF team for sharing. You are all doing incredible work. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.